Have you ever seen this here? This is actually an inductive charging pad, wireless charging for cars, and we can do it with the Porsche Cayenne electric. It's the first car that will offer that from Works, and you can directly order this plate. You just drive over it. You can see in the infotainment system where you exactly need to hit the spot, and the car lowers itself automatically, that it has a closer proximity to the lower charge. It's like 10 centimeters about what is left then, and it can charge up to 11 kilowatts, so similar to a normal wall box where you plug in at home. And the reason behind this is just easier. Now you can see here how the car is lowering itself, starts charging, and 11 kilowatts, it's the same than most usual wall boxes at home, and the efficiency rate is about 90% or even a little bit above that. So there's not so much heat losses or something like that, like you have with normal smartphone wireless charging, and it comes close to the efficiency of a wall box. Wall box is a little bit higher, but there's not much difference. So it's easier, you just drive over it and you can leave it and then it shuts off. But first question that came to my mind, when there's a cat, for example, running under the car, it's automatically shutting off. Also, for example, when I would, you know, get with my foot close here, then it's automatically shutting off so it doesn't damage anyone. And also when you would put a metal, like a coin or something, on top of the plate, it's also shutting off, all for the security reasons. Now we do the test from inside of the vehicle, and you can see here in this infotainment system, everything else is covered still because it's a secret car at this point of shooting. And here we can already see our pet. And we're approaching, we have to stay inside the green lines. And then here, for example, when I would steer this or this way, then it was, that's not good. So we always have to keep the green lines here with the, you know, in line with the pet. And also on the left side, I can see there's this circle. So now I'm approaching, there it is. And then I now have a bigger view of that. And here I have to basically catch the circle. It's like a like a computer game in a little bit. And as soon as the circle is in the other circle, like, there we go. Now, then I have to stop. So now I've put it to P, parking mode, and now the inductive charging should start. I can also stay in the vehicle. Porsche says that's absolutely safe. There we are. So now it should go up to 11 kilowatts. There we go, it's rising. And we have the peak of 11 kilowatt, just like a normal wall box. I can also here decide which state of charge should be the maximum. Of course, most of the time I probably leave it at 80%. And once again, the thing is that when there would be a cat passing by or something like that, or a metal plate, then it should actually shut the system down. And I can also try to test it for you. So at the moment you see it's still charging. And now when I'm reaching with my foot under the vehicle, let's see if it starts stopping, basically. No, maybe with my hand. There we go. So now it has stopped, and I have just, what I've done is, you know, I just put my hand and waved a little bit under the vehicle, simulating a cat with my hand. Now an even closer look and even more information for you. So this is a second sample piece in here. We can also open this service flap. And here underneath you can see, first of all, this is a point where you can actually screw it to the ground. It's not necessary because the weight is about 50 kilograms, so it's heavy enough to stay on the ground, but you could also secure it additionally here. And here you can see this is the fan. It's also waterproof, so it would still work underwater, actually. And yeah, so it's an active cooling underneath. And the length here, by the way, is about 1.17 meters or 46 inches. So it's, you can also see the relation, and it's really not that large. And you will have this one cable then going to your electric supply. And I think in most cases it will be that you might already have a wall box there. And then you will think, what do I do with that? Should I throw it to the trash? So the suggestion by Porsche is that you let like the electrician install a flip switch that you can switch between a wall box and this one. You know, this might be the easiest solution then. Yeah, and what about the pricing? So we have two pieces. So this one here will be around 5,000 euros, and you can order it directly while ordering the new Cayenne electric. And then you need another piece, and that is with the vehicle, and that is right here. So this is the front, and this would be to the vehicle side. And this piece you need in the vehicle. You see here is also screwed there. And you have two solutions. So first of all, you can order like a preset in the configurator for around 200 euros that you maybe can retrofit it later. Or you directly buy it. This is then 2,000 euros in the configuration of the car. So you need like this one here, 2,000 euros plus the 5,000 euros from the pet, plus then the cost for the installation. Either then maybe with a flip switch when you have already wall box, or if you don't have a wall box at all, the installation of this inductive charging pad is actually a little bit easier than just installing a wall box, because you just put it to the ground there. You don't even need to fix it to the ground, and that's it basically. You just need to have the charging supply. So very interesting idea, and of course thinking further, how can you make it even easier? You could let the car drive automatically on the inductive charging pad, you know, but also to be working on soon, and then the car just realizes, ah, okay, I'm closing into the inductive charging pad. You just leave the vehicle, maybe you're already on your way in, and then the car automatically parks on the inductive charging pad. That's like the scenario for the future. By the way, just if you wonder, this is a small screw, so this service flap here, you cannot just open it like this, or you can also take it off completely theoretically, but you have to unscrew it first. So it's not that your neighbor can just like take it off and just, you know, to annoy you or something like that. So you need to unscrew it first. What your neighbor could do to annoy you, maybe don't spread the word, is just place a coin on this plate, you know, on the charging pad. And then you would come with your Cayenne Electric, drive over it, and why doesn't it start charging in the inductive charging? At least the infotainment then shows you, oh, there's a metal object. But always when you annoy your neighbor, then you would just put some small metal object on that one that would prevent the charging actually from it. But you might ask, who would do that? Yeah, everyone has experience with neighbors, right? And you might have already seen this electric Cayenne model here with this special illuminated paint. These are actually multiple layers of paint, and then even more layers and even more layers, and 500 meters of cable and 100 liters of clear coating. So it took like 3 months to create this paint, and it's, yeah, obviously shining. So I've got nothing for the series production model, just something to show off basically together here with the inductive charging pad. Or recently we have already driven the electric Cayenne. It was very impressive. I can recommend you to watch this video if you haven't done so far, especially the acceleration on the German Autobahn. So tune into that video right now.